Opinions and stories around the game we love, told by your favorite storytellers. Stay up to date with all things cricket. Subscribe to CricBuzz's YouTube channel and press that bell icon now.
Every time I've brought up New Zealand, DK, the response has been, be it from people there, is we have so few people, rugby is our first sport, that the kind of pressure that's there for a team like India is not there. These guys are fine. They're playing good cricket. They're enjoying their cricket. Even if they were to win a World Cup, they'll go back and be greeted by friends and family, not by a ticker tape parade.
New Zealand is a great story. I mean, they've had a great time at multi-nation tournaments over a decade now. They've constantly punched above their weight. They're an absolute pleasure to watch. Most importantly, they've had great captains, Martin Crowe, Stephen Fleming, Brendan McCullum. You know, today it is Kane Williamson. They're all leaders of the pack. They're very loyal people. They play a certain brand of cricket and it's a joy to watch them play. You'll never see them behaving badly, never doing anything that is, you know, saying anything unparliamentary. They're so friendly in many ways. You know, a lot of teams, New Zealand have, you know, a lot of imports into the IPL as well these days. So they're a great cricketing nation, one that the ICC should be proud to have because, you know, they always, like I say, punch way above their weight. They are a group of people who play cricket in many ways, like the rugby team, very tight. They, you know, they don't let each other down at any point of time. They have a plan, they play to it. Yes, their expectations are less. Yes, the population is less, but they're still a great country to watch. No matter which part of the world they travel to play the sport, they've been an absolute joy and so well behaved. Like Kane Williamson, even the speech that he gave post the 2019 World Cup loss, you know, just speaks testament of the kind of personality he is, and he's, you know, a great leader. We keep speaking about the MS Dhonis, the Owen Morgans. Kane Williamson is right up there with the best in the world, marshalling troops and resources, you know, having very little to fight with, but always doing well in a battle. And that's been the beautiful part of New Zealand as a cricketing nation. I think they can be really proud of themselves. And I think the World Test Championship was a great example of how the country united once they went back, even though there was, you know, quarantine and all of that. When they did go back, they had a great reception. Those boys had a lot of fun. I was, you know, lucky enough to stay in the same hotel as them when they won it. Even the way they celebrate is so nice to watch. It's they're a great bunch of people.
Yeah, and they've turned up in ICC tournaments. Be it, as DK mentioned, the World Test Championship, it's across formats. That's what they've done so well. Be it putting on the whites or, of course, their coloured jerseys, they've always turned up in ICC tournaments. And, of course, we saw how close they were to winning the 2019 World Cup.
Yeah, and you look at 2019, look at 1990. If you look at the 1992 World Cup, Martin Crowe, just brilliant. You know, Mark Greatbatch there. You know, dipply dobbly bowlers, Gavin Larson, all these guys who just, Deepak Patel opening the bowling as a spinner. And then, if you look at that World Cup, they lost that World Cup for one 45-minute session in which Inzamam took their attack apart. And what had happened at that period, do you remember? Martin Crowe had got a niggle and he'd gone in. And the captain at that point in time was John Wright. He was a senior most guy. He became captain. And in that 45 minutes, Inzamam changed, you know, just took over. Otherwise, if you saw, they had beaten, even Australia, they had beaten. They'd beaten every team out there. And that 45 minutes cost them a World Cup because they were going to go into the finals at that point in time. Yeah, so they're amazing story.